Hey guys, what's going on? Today I'm going to be wearing my San Jose jersey. So just remember that if you guys have any questions about this video, just leave a comment down below. If you have any questions about this video or anything you want me to answer in hockey, I'll answer them for you in the next video and I'll give you a shout out. Okay guys, I'm going to talk about the Brent Johnson and DiPietro fight. So I'm going to show you guys some live commentary of when I watched it, so here it is, check it out. Okay guys, here's my first time watching the Brent Johnson, DiPietro fight. So let's see what we got going here. Here we go. Okay. What the frick? DiPietro, you friggin' dirty little slut! Can't hit a guy like that. Is he okay though? What? Oh, okay, it was Coco got hit. That was friggin' dirty. Wait, what? Oh shit! Brent Johnson's got the fight! Are they gonna let him go? Yes! Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go! Oh, shit! One hit! Oh my god, holy shit! One hit KO! Oh my god, guys, this is ridiculous! Oh, DiPietro, you're a joke, buddy. Oh, freaking Johnson's like, hey, one hit! Oh no! Oh man, everybody's like, what the hell happened? Oh, DiPietro, you're dirty, buddy. Yeah, Penguin bench sub right look for. He's like, yo, my sub, oh my god.
So yeah, so if you guys know Brent Johnson, he's a right-handed guy. He uses his right hand. And he knocked him out. Well, not knocked him out, but he hit him with his left hand, one hit KO. And he was down on his ass, DiPietro, man. What were you thinking? So if some of you don't know, Peter Forsberg is giving the NHL another try. He is signed with the Colorado Avalanche right now for this season. So let's see if he can pull off any leadership or anything because he's kind of old now and his foot's been bothering him. He has foot injuries. So let's just see what he can stir up there. So another thing in the news would be Fleury has his own cereal now for just the time being. They're called Fleury Flakes. So if any of you guys have any of these, I really want them. So please send them to me. That would be amazing if I got some from one of you guys. That would be awesome. I'd give you guys a big shout out and I'll make a little video on the side of me trying to eat them and shit. It'd be hilarious. So Craig Conroy announced his retirement on Friday. He scored 182 goals and he had 542 points after 16 seasons and 1,000 games in the NHL. Congrats, buddy. Have fun on the retirement. In 1,009 games, he played for Montreal, St. Louis, Calgary, and Los Angeles Kings. So Darylin Boyce went face first into the one of the camera slot things in last week's game, and he injured his nose. He broke his nose. I'll just let you guys watch this clip right quick.
Tender, last season the American Hockey League.
Yeah, South Carolina Stingrays. Once upon a time, coached by his first 8 games.
The pictures of the aftermath is online, but they are extremely gruesome to say the least. He tore his left nostril off his face. He needed over a dozen stitches to put his nose back together. I'm gonna have a link down below and it's gonna show the picture of when he got his nose put back together. It's really gruesome, so I advise you guys to don't click it if you have a weak stomach. Okay guys, now let's talk some injuries. So Evgeny Malkin is out now for the rest of the season and the starter of next season. He tore his ACL and MCL. So now the Pittsburgh Penguins have a big cap space to fill. They have over $8 million they can fill with their new cap space. So they're going to be looking for a new player, like forward. With Crosby coming back and Marco Testu coming back, they need a. Their goaltending's fine, their defense is fine. They just need a right wing to help them out so that fill in for Malkin. So talk's been going around saying, you know. So Jerome Iginla plays for the Calgary Flames, and for the past 2 years, he's been in talk for trade and stuff. So do you guys think that maybe Jerome might go to the Pittsburgh Penguins since they have such a big cap space to fill? Do you think maybe they'll pick him up off Calgary in the trade deadline? You guys tell me down below, who do you think Jerome might... Do you think he'll stay in Calgary, or do you think he'll maybe go to Pittsburgh or another team? Just guys, let me know in the comments down below. So goaltender Martin Brodeur of the New Jersey Devils is now out due to injury. Took a slap shot to his right knee and there was some bruising, so he might be out for a little bit. Isles goaltender DiPietro, he is out for 4 to 6 weeks with a fractured cheekbone. Oh, another excuse for DiPietro to not play for the Islanders. Isn't it kind of suspicious how it's always like, oh, I'm injured. Oh, I can't play. Oh, something happened. The Islanders are getting screwed over. Now it's time to answer your guys' questions from last week's video. Now remember, if you want me to answer your guys' questions and give you guys a shout out, leave a question down below in this video and I'll answer it next week. So let's get started. First question is from Jimbo3394 and he asks, the Rangers seem to have hit a rough patch after the All-Star break. Do you think they'll turn it around or fall out of the playoff picture? Well, I think the Rangers will make the playoffs. They have a pretty strong team right now. If King Lundqvist keeps playing the way he plays, like he's an amazing goaltender. So I think it all depends on how he plays and how the rest of the team plays. But I know they'll make the playoffs this year for sure. So let's see if my prediction's right. Next question comes from Hockey Chapels, and he asks, what do you have to say about the Canucks? Will they win the Cup? The Canucks are a pretty strong team with the Sedins and friggin' Luongo. Like, their team is jacked. They have the players. I'm pretty sure they won't let you down. They'll make the playoffs. It's hard to say right now, but they are a strong team, and I'm pretty sure they'll win a Cup, not if this year, but if next year, they will. This next question comes from Belief X, and he asks, do you think the Islanders will make the playoffs or win the Cup this year?
No.
That's all the questions for this week. Remember to leave one down below, and I'll answer it next week. So subscribe so that this hockey community can grow even more. Add me as a friend. We have a Facebook, National Flair, search it up. Like it. We need more followers on that. Thanks. I'll see you guys the next time a big hockey news story comes out. See you then.